The Tigers are in the top 10 once again. The Tiger Football Report, brought to you by the Green Turtle, starts now. Welcome to another edition of the Tiger Football Report. I'm your host, Spiro Marikas, along with the head coach of the Tigers, Rob Ambrose. And Coach, the Tigers break into the top 10 this week at number 8 in the nation after the victory over the Citadel. I know you don't care about that kind of stuff. This week, North Carolina Central comes to Johnny Unitas Stadium. I know any opponent is somebody you're going to want to beat up, but you're happy that you're going to have the opportunity to beat them up at Johnny Unitas Stadium.
Yes, we are happy to come home. I'm looking forward to playing in front of our fan base, in front of our community, on our home turf, in front of our students.
Students that aggravate the opponents.
Yes, they're my favorite. Well, graduates are my favorite, but the second favorite are the ones who come to games on Saturday and have a really good time. They have fun, they're smart, they're safe, but they make it brutal for the other team to function. So I'm looking forward to seeing you guys.
And you have said that other coaches have mentioned that to you.
Over the last 10 years, especially from 2010 to 2014, it was at the point where it was commentary whenever we met as coaches. Like, are your kids going to not be there? Can we schedule at a time when the kids don't come to the games? Like, coaches from other teams in our conference have a legitimate fear of our student section. And I love that.
All right, so this week you play North Carolina Central, a team the Tigers haven't played in about 5 years. The Eagles come in. They lost last week to Austin Peay. When you look at them, what do they do from the offensive side of the football?
They mix it up. They spread it out. They got a lot of good athletes. They were shuttling two quarterbacks in last week and playing two different style guys. Get the ball in the hands of a lot of different kids and make plays. And they, too, kind of suffered. They got behind a little bit early and had a hard time catching up offensively. Defensively, they're running a brand-new scheme with a new coordinator, but from what I can tell, they look very, very sound. They gap sound, gap specific, position specific stuff. So we talked about this today after practice, and that if you're really going to be a championship football team, you need to stop talking about the other people you play. And week after week, it's not about them. You know, I think the Patriots really talk about who they're going to go play. It's about what they do and how they do it week after week after week. So we're going to focus on us and make sure we got our I's dotted and our T's crossed, but it's going to be about us.
In looking back over Saturday's game, Shane Simpson scores 3 touchdowns. He had 150-some total yards of offense with receiving, rushing, and returns. But he only touched the ball 15 times during the game. To you, that's probably the best of both worlds, isn't it? Because this is a long season, and you don't want your star running back getting beat up.
Surviving the game versus the Citadel, where the defense has to sit in a 60-minute punching bag telephone booth of a game. Conversely, the offense, while almost having 500 yards offense, only ran 59 plays, which is 20 to 30 plays less than what you're used to. So if you look at what the score was and what the stats were, statistically we were solid and strong, and we made the most of our opportunities for the most part. We don't fumble the ball on the 1 yard line, and Shane catches the ball in the end zone and then gets it knocked out of his hands. There's 14 points, different ball game. 59 plays is not a lot of plays. Offensively, we're pretty fresh. Defensively, we're sore. We're very sore. But offensively, we're very fresh.
Do you take that into account as practice starts this week, that your defense was out on the field a lot because of the way the Citadel plays?
Oh, gosh, yes. And as we talked about recovery time, and this is probably good for young kids, like, the defense doesn't feel tired now. We just won a game. It's Labor Day. Labor Day happened. Time off, It catches up to you 10 days after, 14 days after, those big ones. And the conversation is, got to eat right, got to sleep right, got to take care of your body, got to rest your body, got to ice and soak as much as you can to try to get some of that resiliency back. And it, even though you don't feel like you're drained, you are. And that's the only way to refill your tank.
Now, if you're at North Carolina Central and they're looking at the Towson game film from this past week, they really can't see too much defensively because you basically had to run the same thing all the time because the Citadel runs the same thing all the time.
The only way they know anything about our defensive scheme, unless they've decided to change the triple option this week, would be to call around and try to figure out what Eric's done at other places. So what we had trouble facing for the entirety of camp, they're going to have trouble facing for the entirety of Saturday.
On the offensive side, you put up, as you mentioned, almost 500 yards of offense. You scored 28 points. You left points on the field. What I, seeing the team for the first time, you've got a lot of weapons on offense.
And it is.
They can't stick to one guy.
No, and honestly, it took me a while to figure some of it out. If you go back in last year when we were playing the Citadel at home, Tom really hurt them with his legs. And he threw the ball well, but he hurt them with his legs. And they weren't going to let him run. And it took me about a quarter to figure out what it is that they were really trying to get after. And after that, Shane took off, you know, put the ball in everybody else's hands. And we spread it out. Everybody got a little bit of something. And it makes, if we're that functional with that many guys and that explosive with that many guys, we are hard to defend. We are.
North Carolina Central will try to defend the Tigers this Saturday. Gordy Combs and I will have the call for you starting at 5:45 on CBS Sports Radio 1300 and TowsonTigers.com. So for the head coach of the Tigers, Rob Ambrose, I'm Spiro Marikas. Thanks for watching, and as always, go Tigers.